I like it. Well, the first thing I do is I put a little olive oil. We got these steaks already nice and olive oiled up. And then I like to go ahead and give it a good dose of seasoning. The thing is, especially with these thicker steaks, you really need to get that outside seasoned up well, because that middle isn't going to get any of that seasoning, right? That right there is kosher salt. Yeah, I live and die by the kosher salt. Sea salt is great for finishing, like at the very end, you know? If you would, give those guys a flip for me. Now, it's good that you get both sides of your steak oiled up and seasoned up really well. That's how we do it here at STK. Yes, sir. Now, there's a couple other things that I like to do, especially when you get into these thinner steaks. These right here are Wagyu steaks, and they're from Australia. It's a really high grade of Wagyu. Now, when I have something thin like this, I tend to hit it with a little bit of this, what I have here is red wine blood. Basically, I reduce some red wine, and I get that nice and reduced, and then I fold it into some whole butter. And what that does is it helps me get a good caramelization on the outside without overcooking the inside. So we'll see how that works for us. Let's see, I think this is a 20. Like I said, that's something that we can go ahead and let rest. And we're still working this. This is the, that's the filet. That's your gut, right? Yeah, these are a little thicker, so they're going to go. These steaks. Exactly, that's a good point. Especially the fact that it's a ribeye. It's marbleized with a lot of fat. And fat's basically oil, right? So that heats up, and that continues to stay hot. So it's just like you say, in the middle of that steak, it's still cooking. Alright, now we get those guys going. Now I think it's your turn. When you're in the pocket, how is it that you know, when you're about to give that pass, like, do you already know where you're going? Or you gotta check each guy? Because I see you checking each guy, but I can't believe you guys have enough time to really do that.
You're reading the defense, you have a play call, you know, kind of that certain down and distance situation, but they might, you know, give you something hidden that you're not expecting, so you always have to be on top of your game. It's all nothing but a chess game, you know. I'm thinking that they're gonna do a certain thing in the situation, so we call a certain play for that situation. And if it becomes up something different, you better have your radar going and knowing
radar.
Right.
You can't say, hey, four seconds, you stand right there and you're okay.
Yeah, I can't just say 4 minutes on one side of that snake, or I can't say 4 seconds on the football. Sometimes I got to get out here at 2.2.
No doubt.
I might have 5, 6 seconds to sit back here. So the field thing in football is just like in the kitchen.
No doubt. Yeah. No doubt. That's awesome. So you guys have, you're putting together a pretty awesome charity to help give people some chances to get out of their situation.
We really are. It's been a very successful thing for us for about the last 11 years. Las Vegas community has been great to us as far as supporting the job. So I think everybody coming here putting some event on is just like STK. This is an event for us tonight.
Yeah.
We're going to have some top caliber celebrities here. We're going to have some great sponsors who are really giving a lot of money to make this event happen. And then all of our scholarship winners will be here. A couple here from Las Vegas.
I'm excited to be
here. The other eight from all over the country.
What does it take for them to win that scholarship? I mean, I imagine there must be a lot of
yeah, we have an application process that they have to go through. They have to submit an essay about why they think they deserve the scholarship. They have to submit their grades, of course, and some financial background, their families. So, and they have to be involved in their community wherever they are.
Oh, okay.
We want kids that are giving back already.
Oh, that's
all
awesome.
These kids are doing that.
Right on. Well, our 20 is resting out pretty nicely. We do have just a little bit to go for medium on these guys. You want to get back there and flip those guys for me? You can see that butter's really helped out. You gave us a little.
I've never heard of that before. I'm probably going to have to do
it. You know, it works on those clear cups, man. Those clear cups of meat. Just
reduce
want to
that
get
wine
it.
Down, huh?
Just reduce that red wine.
Yeah,
and you know what?
Butter.
I also finish like that, too. So at the end, you put that over, and that red wine, when it reduces, it kind of translates into sweetness.
Okay.
It basically takes that the liquid out of the wine, but it leaves that residual sugar, right? And that residual sugar and that grape flavor of the wine, you know? And then you finish that on the steak, I think you guys will see that it has a great flavor to it.
And then you finish that wine with another glass of a really good cab.
My friend, yeah. Now you're doing all right.
You got a meal working there.
You got a meal working.
how quickly those cook, you need to kind of cheat a little bit and give it something to get that caramelization on the outside of that meat. Whereas these big boys, you know, they need a little time, but I think we're getting really close on these big boys right here.
So I'm on this back over here. Is that a certain type of beef? Is they raised a certain way in Australia? Do they feed it something different, or is it different?
Well, I think all of the above. The Wagyu beef, Wagyu is the type of cow.
Yeah.
And basically, in Australia, they do the full breed of Wagyu. So it's a Wagyu mom and a Wagyu dad. And then they get the steers there. And then once they get these steers, they feed it just about anything under the sun to fatten it up. And as you saw when we went to cook those steaks in the beginning, you see those really tight kernels of caramelization. Now that's what's going to translate into flavor in the steak. Now, here in America, yeah, that's it. It's that flat. And you know, it's kind of a payoff because you also got to watch that. You know, you're going to have more fat, so it's like you take like this piece of meat right here, that's the filet. Now that's going to be tender all the way through. You can cut it with a spoon and eat that. Whereas a ribeye, you're going to have to work a little bit harder. Exactly the point. So that tends to be one of my favorite pieces of meat right there. Well, Kobe is the area.
Yeah, probably has a lot more.
Well, it's the same thing, actually. Kobe is an area in Japan.
Right.
It's like kind of saying, like Band-Aids are the same as adhesive Band-Aids.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, it's a brand name. Kobe is a place in Japan, and you can only call it Kobe if it's from that area. Now, the type of cow in Kobe, the area, is the Wagyu beef. So, Australia, they do their beef as close to the way as they do it in Japan. Like that's the closest you're gonna get to the true Japanese style. In America, we're a little bit changed up. Like, instead of feeding our cows beer, we feed our cows McDonald's French fries. And I know it sounds like a joke, but it's straight up.
I'm
we do anything.
We feed our kids that.
Right?